It's Sunday and it's gorgeous. It's about 45 degrees. It was actually frost on all the cars this morning and not even a single cloud in the sky. So I'm gonna work on the good old Astro. I already put my crap underneath here. So what we're doing today is a starter, which seems like it's the easiest starter I've ever done. It's basically all you got is these two bolts, which are so easy to access, and then the wires, and you pull the whole thing off. Okay, so I got one bolt out. Now I'm working on the second bolt. You might need the couple extensions. These are like 3-inch extensions, 3/8, and the socket is 13 millimeter. You know, it's American car, but yeah, everything's metric. And then and you do these bolts first, then you get the wires. It's kind of hard to get to the wires, so I figure I'll take the bolts out, take the starter out, and then I can easily get the wires off. So, but because of these transmission lines cooling, they're cooling the transmission fluid. They're kind of in the way, and you can't put a ratchet in there. You don't have no room to play with it, so you need two extensions just in case. So, or one long extension, whatever works, you know. And that's about it. Oh, and the last thing, you gotta disconnect the negative battery terminal, obviously. Because this wire, this is very thick wire. It's like a 2-gauge or 1-gauge. And it's hot. It's a positive red wire that goes right to the starter. That's how all starters are. They're always hot all the time. And on the solenoid also, the solenoid works like a relay too. Not only kicks the little gear, but it also connects that hot wire to the electric motor. And that's how basically all the starters work. When you turn the ignition, this hot wire here fires up the solenoid, which also makes a connection. And it fires up the starter. So the wire up there is always hot. So if you don't disconnect the negative battery terminal, you're gonna see some fireworks. So just remember to do that. So after removal of the second bolt, the starter just practically drops on your head. And here are the wires, very exposed. Now you can take them out easily and then put a new starter in. And that's it. So do it yourself. I paid, I think, $90 for the starter. Of course, you go to a mechanic, you're going to pay at least $250, $300, because they're going to charge you AutoZone. I bought my starter online, so it's much cheaper. AutoZone carries them for about $180. Plus the mechanic's gonna charge you again a minimum 1 hour labor, so you're gonna pay $300 for a new starter. When you can get it for $90 though yourself. I'm just gonna show you how clean this car is. Look at it. There's not a single these are rocker panels. This is what I mean. This is the reason I bought this car. Look at it. Even where the bolts are. What this usually the wheel wells here, that's usually always corrodes. This here, even the tiny sheet metal. Like I said, this thing was only driven in the summer, in July and August. And you can see, look at the brake lines. Okay, you gotta see these brake lines. Usually they corrode first. This car is, you know, 12 years old. By then, usually you have to replace the brake lines because they'll pop, actually. They'll break somewhere because they're so corroded. As you can see, there's really not a speck of rust on any of them. There's some surface rust on a few things that are just exposed right to the gravel, kicking up, like you see it in here. There's some surface rust, but and a little bit here. But really, that's about it. I mean, the whole body is just shiny everywhere. It's not a... Even look at the manifold. This is your manifold, and that's your exhaust. Usually these bolts are so corroded, you will never be able to take them apart. I can take this whole exhaust and unscrew it with ease. That's how clean this car is. That's the reason I bought it. When I brought this light and I dove underneath this car, when I saw this, that there was literally not a speck of rust anywhere, I knew I had to buy it. But it was a summer camp. They had a whole fleet of these vans, and they only use them in the summer, and that's the difference. That's why I buy always cars from Florida. When you have no, I mean, look in there. When you have no salt, the car looks brand new underneath, even if it's 12 years old. It's amazing. It's all done. Here's the old one. The car's running. The new one's in. It took about half an hour. Here's the new one. So, it was about half an hour total. Easy job, very easy. Hopefully in the 1 hour I replaced the alternators, the starter, all the bearings everywhere. I have to do the seal. I don't know if I show you this before or not. I have a bad seal on the input shaft going into the drive shaft. You can see just how wet it is. See all this wetness? That's that seal that's bad over there. It's not really bad, it's not leaking. I've never seen a single drip, but it's wet over there, which means it's going bad. And I already bought the seal, so I'm gonna do that probably next weekend. Gonna drive this thing for a week, make sure nothing else is a problem before I start doing the camper conversion. I wanna make sure this thing is just top shape. So, thanks for watching.